American Airlines has revealed this week that it wants to go supersonic. The US airline has agreed to a purchase of 20 of the Boom Supersonic Overtures with an option to add up to 40 more. The airline has done more than just announce its intent to purchase, as it has paid a non-refundable deposit on its first 20 aircraft. Let's learn more about this significant decision in today's video. In a statement on August 16th, American Airlines Chief Financial Officer Derek Kerr commented, "Looking to the future, supersonic travel will be an important part of our ability to deliver for our customers. We're excited about how Boom will shape the future of travel both for our company and our customers." American Airlines has become the second major US airline to indicate its interest in the new supersonic jet. In June last year, United Airlines became Boom's first USA customer, placing an order for 15 Overtures with options for 35 more. Although United was first, American's commitment is larger, something well befitting of the world's largest airline by fleet size. Founder and CEO of Boom Supersonic, Blake Scholl, noted the importance of securing a commitment from a world-leading airline like American, saying, "We are proud to share our vision of a more connected and sustainable world with American Airlines. We believe Overture can help American deepen its competitive advantage on network, loyalty, and overall airline preference through the paradigm-changing benefits of cutting travel times in half." As well as the two US airlines, Boom has also received a 20-plane pre-order from Japan Airlines, announced back in 2017. Its order book, including purchases and options, now stands at 130 aircraft. Boom unveiled its revised production design for the Overture at the recent Farnborough Air Show. This included swapping a trijet design for a quadjet arrangement, as well as redesigning the new gull wing and employing area rolling for optimal aerodynamic performance. According to its timeline, the Overture should be rolled out for the first time in 2025, with entry into service targeted at 2029. But there's a long way to go before Boom Supersonic gets to those milestones. While certification and flight testing will clearly be a long and challenging process, one of the more pressing problems is to find and announce an engine maker for the jet. Boom has opted for four smaller size engines over three big ones, partly as it believes it can achieve Mach 1.7 with existing technology. However, a partnership with an engine manufacturer remains the biggest obstacle to overcome. It is hoped an announcement on this will be made in the next few months. Traveling at Mach 1.7 over water, the aircraft could cut flying times in half on some of the most lucrative travel corridors. Think London to Miami in less than 5 hours, or New York to Frankfurt in under four.
Well, that's great. It also means the annoying guy who's sitting next to you on the plane is going to have to talk twice as fast now. It's going to be like, "So yeah, you fly often, you're going on vacation, is it the work thing? I just had to check a bag. You're checking a bag? Where are you from? Yeah, first time you're flying? Yeah, the plane, you've seen the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, it's going to be great. And we're here."
The Overture will play a key role in similar markets as Concorde once did, allowing business people to be there in person for important events and still be back in their hometown for dinner. United has undoubtedly seen the potential benefit and, not wanting to be left behind, American has jumped on the bandwagon as well. Could we see an order from one of the other transatlantic stalwarts, like BA, Delta, or perhaps Lufthansa? Let us know what you think by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.